watch our food.
Come on now.
And my God. He's the same God. Yesterday, today, and forever. He changed not. We change, but God does not change. We stop believing God, but He does not change. We lose our faith, but God does not change.
In my mind, I wanted to know what was the significance behind marching for 7 days. And I kept wondering that in my mind. The Holy Spirit told me He did that for some of us. He did that for you. He did that to show you that sometimes, even though things might not happen right then, He want to let you know that He hasn't forgot about you. It may be delayed, but baby, it ain't denied. If God said, you might as well bank on it. My mama said, you can take that to the bank. You can cash that. He hasn't forgotten about us. We must understand the principles behind one of God's promises. In the book of Hebrews 16:6-18, He tells us that it is impossible for God to lie. In Numbers 23:19, it says, God is not a man that He should lie, neither the Son of Man that He should repent. He hath said, and shall He not do? Or hath He spoken, and He shall not make it good? If God said it, you can believe it. I'm trying to get people in their mind. If God made you a promise, you ought to get happy glad, because He can't lie. It may not be what it is supposed to be right now, but you ought to just wait on Him and know that God is coming through. He may have promised you that house. They got to tell folk, I don't got the house now, but I know God's coming through. He might have told you He's going to heal you. They ought to tell somebody, I already got the healing. I wait for sickness to leave my body. You ought to tell somebody, I already got the call. I wait for the keys to come into my hand. If God said it, if God said it, He can do it. Tell somebody, He's able. He's able. Yes, He is. Yes, He is. Yeah, Lord. So He led them to their promise with a shout. I wonder, is there anybody in here that got a shout? I'm not talking about a two-step, but I'm talking about a shout. Are you okay? I feel somebody to shout.
We have a misconception of the Holy Ghost. And not only that, but there's too many people who call themselves believers who have not received the baptism of the Holy Ghost. What blows my mind is that we have too many comfortable, content, and complacent believers who sing in the choir and on the praise team and preach in the pulpit and serve on the deacons and the mother's board and assemble themselves into the house of God on a weekly basis and are just as satisfied as they can be without being filled with the Holy Ghost. Not only that, but they look at those of us who have been filled with the Holy Ghost as if we have lost our mind. Oh, I wish I had an amen or two in the house. But if you don't say nothing, that's right.
Without power, without power, we might as well close. Can I tell you, we want the power before the Holy Ghost.
misconception. But the evidence of the Holy Ghost is power. Yeah. Look at somebody and grab them by the hand and say, do you got power?
And I'm going to let you know what the devil meant for your evil. God is going to turn it around for good. I don't know what you've been going through. I don't know what you've been suffering with. I don't know the issues that you face. I don't know the trials and tribulations that you face. But I come to let you know what you're going through is only a setup of what God is getting ready to take you to. Somebody should have got happy right there. What you are going through is only a stepping stone to put you in the face of God. What you are going through is only a test and a trial. You say you want something from God. God want to know, how bad do you want it? You say you want to be blessed, but how bad do you want your blessing? You say you want to be filled with the Holy Ghost, but what are you doing in order to get it? Oh my God, this thing is not cheap. Many people, you will ask God for everything, but you're never willing to give God anything. If you want God to do something for you that he never that he's never done before, you must do something for God that you've never done before. I wish I had a witness. I wish I was in a sanctified church, a hand clapping, foot stomping, tongue talking, Pentecostal, Church of God in Christ. We need to make it up in our mind that we're tired of church as usual, but it's time to get with one accord. Oh God, you want to make it up in your mind. Bust your bubbles for a moment. I'm tired of youth revivals. That ain't nothing but a social event. I did not come out here to socialize. I didn't come out here to make a friend. But I came out here to have an encounter with God. You need to make it up in your mind that I want an encounter with God. I want to experience God. I want God to fill me with the Holy Ghost. I want the real thing. Tell your neighbor. Say, neighbor.